Hello students, now I will discuss about the structure of a sperm. Before this, I want to know that you know about sperm. What is sperm? Sperm is a gamete. Sperm is a gamete, male gamete. It is a male gamete. And the formation of sperm is known as spermiogenesis. Okay? In yesterday's lecture, we learned about spermatogenesis, oogenesis. So, the formation of sperm is spermatogenesis, having two or three phases. Okay? Now, what is the ploidy of this sperm? Always haploid. Because there is meiotic division. After the meiotic division, this cell is formed. So, it is always in haploid. They are in haploid. They have half set of chromosomes number. Okay? They have only 23 chromosomes, not 46. They have half set. Okay? Now, this is the structure of a sperm. This is the structure of a sperm which is in motile. Which is motile means they are capable to move. Because they have tail. And this structure is the structure of a sperm having three main parts. One is head and mid portion, there is a middle portion, and last one is tail. So these are the main regions of its body. In head region, if we talk about head region, there are PM, that is plasma membrane, which is, you know, plasma membrane. The cell is surrounded by a outer membrane, and that membrane is known as plasma membrane. It also have a plasma membrane. It is a cell beta. This is a cell. Okay, and you know, cell have all organelle. But this is not in a circle. Its shape is elongate shape. Okay, then its whole part covered by a PM, that is plasma membrane. This portion is acrosome. This portion is acrosome. Outer portion called acrosome. It is a modification of Golgi. It is a modification of Golgi apparatus. The Golgi apparatus, you know, Golgi apparatus present in the cell. This is the modification of Golgi apparatus called acrosome. Now, this portion is nucleus. This portion is nucleus having chromosomal material. This is the neck. This region is neck. Now, this portion is middle portion having mitochondria. You know, this one, this cylindrical body, you see, this cylindrical body, this is mitochondria. This is mitochondria. And what is the role of this mitochondria? It is the energy sources for what? It is the energy sources for the swimming of the sperm. You know, sperm is move, sperm can move. So, for its movement, it needs some energy. So, this energy source is mitochondria. Because mitochondria is the powerhouse of a cell. Because ATP generate there. Okay? So, this is mitochondria. It provide energy. And this portion is tail. This portion is tail. So, this is a structure of a sperm, you call spermatozoa. From spermatids, spermatozoa are formed. Spermatozoa also called sperm. It's a structure, elongate structure, having three regions, head, middle portion, and tail. Now, listen. Sperm have three major regions, that is head, middle piece, and tail. Okay, head is elongated haploid nucleus having haploid nucleus, cap-like structure called acrosome, and this acrosome, actually this acrosome having some lytic enzyme. That enzyme help in fertilization in the body of female. when this sperm is going to the body of female, then fertilization occur. When the sperm and ovum are fused, fertilization occur, and for the fusion, for the fertilization, they have some enzymes, and at that time the function of enzyme is occur, help in fertilization. Now there is middle piece. Middle piece, numerous mitochondria, having numerous mitochondria, produces energy for the sperm motility, and which is essential for fertilization. If the sperm is not motile, then how it reaches to the female body? When mating occur, how it is released? No. So the sperm motility, it need energy, and this energy come from this mitochondria. Tail for the movement, because it this sperm has to reach to the female part, female sex organ. So for this reason, it travel from the seminiferous tubule to the urethra, and then at mating it release to the female body part through vagina. It goes to the uterus and then in fallopian tube, where the ovum waiting for sperm and fertilization occur. So this whole path it travel, and for this traveling it needs movement, and this tail help in the movement. Which structure it cross? It form in seminiferous tubule, then seminiferous tubule, vas deferentia, then epididymis, then vas deferens, then urethra, and then out of the penis, glans penis, during mating it released to the female reproductive part. So now this structure is complete. Sperm structure is complete. If you have any query related to its structure, or the structure of ovary, or the structure of male reproductive system, or the structure of female reproductive system, please ask me. Thank you.